Welcome, ladies. What a fun video I have in store for you today. It is about summer accessorizing with one of my favorite accessories of all time, the hat. It is such a chic and elegant way to up your game, to separate you from the pack, and to make you stand out from the rest. And I don't know why hats are that way now. Do you remember in yesteryear, in old Hollywood, you would always see women with hats, hats with suits, hats with dresses. Hats were such a part of the overall look, the overall presentation, and somehow during the years, we've sort of parted ways with the hat. Well, I am here to say, bring it back. Rock your hat. It serves a multitude of purposes this summer. Number one, it is excellent face and neck and even shoulder protection, depending on how wide your brim is. So it's protecting your skin. Number two, when it gets hot and humid and the hair isn't behaving, you know what? Slick it back, tuck it behind a hat, and nobody will ever know. And number three, if your hair is dirty and you don't want to mess with it, yet again, another opportunity for a hat. Hats these days are incredibly affordable. In fact, a majority of the ones that I'm going to show you today are from a website called hatsinthebelfry.com. I've bought most of my hats there. The others I've picked up whenever I travel, and if I see a hat store, I have to pop in and see the latest and greatest. But first and foremost, with a blouse like I have on right now, just something very fresh and summery and light, you can take a hat like a fedora. A straw fedora will go miles when it comes to hat wear during the summer because they can be either dressed up or dressed down. With something like this, I have a beige fedora. And the other advantage of a hat, and especially a fedora, because they tend to be a little bit taller, is that they can also elongate the face and help to either accentuate some assets or even make things look a little bit better. So with something like this, I would just take a fedora and pop it on, pull the hair back a little bit. The other beauty of the hat is that you want to be able to show your face. So you just take your hair, you can even slick it back in a ponytail or just tuck it lightly behind the ears and you are good to go. But again, it just completely changes the look of what it is that you're wearing. And like I said, it bumps it up and it brings you into a level of style and sophistication that maybe you won't find on other people. And if you're looking for a way to separate yourself, we always think jewelry and sunglasses for the summer. I'm encouraging you to think about a hat. So a fedora like this can go a long way with something like what I'm wearing, with even jeans and a t-shirt and some lace-up heels. You'd be amazed at what it could do for that. So again, a basic neutral straw fedora is the ticket for almost anything and everything. So if you were to start from basically nowhere and purchase your first hat, I would highly recommend something like this. Just more bang for the buck. Now the next step, and you can elevate it to this, since the Kentucky Derby is behind us, but it really inspires very ornate and decorative hats. And if you're looking to go to that level, then you can find something like this, which has a cute little pom-pom right here on front. But it's precious and it's decorative. And again, it's just another way to say, chic. I'm outside the box. I'm outside the hat box. So this is really fun. And I can even pair this with something very light and whimsical, like this off the shoulder dress that I have. That's very summery, that also plays into the trend of the summer, which is exposed shoulder and asymmetrical. So something like this really makes it even lighter and airier and a little bit more whimsical. So again, you can get very creative and decorative with your hats too. You don't have to be conservative. But again, I love this hat with this particular dress because I find it very flirty and romantic. Okay, so next up is more of a wider brim hat. And this is blue with sort of a pale blue and gray band. And you can do something like this with a sundress, but what I'm going to pair this with is another really popular trend of the season, and that is stripes. So here are some flared pants that are blue and white striped, along with a blouse, again, striped, cropped at the waist. And this hat sort of brings in the color, but it also really ups the game with style. You know, Katharine Hepburn was the queen of hats. And I just love something like this with a denim relaxed look. I think it makes it look more chic and elegant and is very playful. And again, offers you incredible sun protection if you are out in a warm destination for travel. I cannot say enough good stuff about hats and not only how they'll really make you look incredible, but the protection that they offer. And I just think it's so chic and fun to be able to tie it all together. The next one that I want to show you is really for beach wear. And that's when you see most of the hats, either poolside or oceanside. So I want to give you a couple of alternatives for that. It's really fun to dress up our swimsuits with our cover-ups, our sunglasses, but bring a hat into the equation that either goes with your cover-up or your bathing suit or both. So again, very popular poolside is the fedora. I love the white fedora, whether I have a white bathing suit or a black bathing suit. I put this on with my swimsuit, with my cover-up and my sunglasses, and I just think it ties it all together, gives great sun protection. This one with the fedora, not as much. This is just a little bit more face protection. That's about it. But it's just so stinking cute. And so if you're looking for more face protection, I found something like this. And this is genius, whoever came up with this idea. So it's a wide brim hat, but look what they do in the back. It's completely flat. So you have the opportunity to wear a hat and lay back in a lounge chair and have the back of your head rest comfortably against a lounge chair without the back brim of a hat getting squished back there. So this is magnificent. So here you go. You've got full coverage, face, neck, shoulders, and you can lay back with your shades, read your book, and you are good to go with all of your protection. But, and you're chic, and you're stylish, and you've stepped up your game with a simple little hat. So there you go. These are 5 samples of different hats and different styles that you can pull together. Again, very affordable. I am not looking to make you break the bank to have style and sophistication. These all can be accomplished very reasonably. It's just a matter of looking and hunting. That's what I'm here for. I'm your scavenger. I think Hats in the Belfry is an amazing find. Not to mention just the fun of being able to pop into a hat store whenever you're out and about. But, you know, go through your closet, look at some of your dresses, your outfits, things that would lend themselves to a hat. Look at the color schemes and see what would work best, whether it's white, black, neutral, a blue, and start with your basic colors, build up from there. Have a great time experimenting with this. Not everything fits everybody. Not every hat fits everybody. It's a unique discovery, but finding something that works for you and that makes your soul sing is just the most wonderful feeling. So I encourage you to experiment, have fun, and give her a go. Comments, ideas, suggestions. I'm thinking maybe since we did hats, maybe jewelry, summer jewelry for casual as well as business, because I do believe that there are certain rules, but things that just make sense. Let's put it that way. But if you're thinking something else, please let me know below in the comment section. Follow me on social media and KPRC Channel 2 at 6 and 10, as well as my station's website, click2houston.com. You can see the newscast stream live. So with your summer style and your protection, go out, be bold, be blessed this week, and I'll see you next time. Bye.